Now it's time for the soft eyes. So I'm using on Lisa a little bit smokier. Lisa, which one do you prefer? Like a brown smoky eye or a black?
Or a black. I like a charcoal brown.
Charcoal brown? Yes.
Is there such a thing?
Yes, there is. I am carrying like, also. I have this amazing.
Like that type of a brown.
Yes, even I have this nice tone. This is from Huda. This is from MAC. These are the two same colors.
I think this is the one that I usually use at home.
Yeah, this is really nice.
As well,
exactly. So yeah. Multiple use you guys have with this color. It's like a brown filler also. So also, guys, really important if you guys are makeup artists, and especially when you guys are doing makeup for a bride, and she knows me, I always ask my client actresses, what do you like? Because that's their big bridal day. So if you guys are their makeup artist, or if there are brides who wants to get ready, please ask the bride, because she is going to see the pictures for the rest of her life. So I always ask my clients how they want to look, because we do the makeup and we go away a little bit. If you have creative ideas, please share it with the actress. But otherwise, always listen, because they are standing in front of the camera and they will see themselves. So never be really difficult as a makeup artist, I would say. So this is my opinion.
That's actually one of the nice things about Shaan. I remember, like, I would always give him feedback and things that I knew about my face, and he wouldn't take it personally. And I think that's a nice thing when you can be able to, like, communicate with someone and tell them what you feel, and then they're not, like, offended or upset about it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then you want to keep working with them over and over again, because you know that they want to make you happy, and your best work is their best work, and vice versa.
Yeah, that's so true.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do a little bit cutting on Lisa's eyes. Now, close your eyes. So I'm going to start from the outer corner of her eyes to get that nice brown effect. And now with a softer color of brown, which you guys can see. Look straight, Lisa. I'm going to contour it in so that I get the crease line really nice and defined.
One thing I noticed Shaan does, if I can say right now,
yes.
A lot of people tend to contour above the brow line up here, and
yes.
It ends up looking quite garish.
Exactly.
Whereas if you're noticing right now, Shaan is doing it on the lower part of the crease line to keep the eye smoky and dense.
And as you guys can see, Lisa has already really huge eyes, like really big eyes. So you guys can actually play around more. But yeah, when you go really high,
it makes them bigger.
Yeah, makes them bigger. And as Lisa said, there should be never lines. And I'm very used to do my eyeshadow with my fingers, which you guys have already seen. So I prefer to do it with my hands more, because I always feel it blends more. I'm keeping this look of Lisa really soft. So now to get that little sheen, I'm going to use the Tom Ford eyeshadow palette. So you guys can use it with your hands. You guys can wet this also a little bit and do it. So I'm using it with my fingers first, because I always feel with the fingers, it comes really, the effect comes much more. And it has this really beautiful glitter. Can you guys see this? So your finger is really a good tool to start with. And you guys can get that really sheen, because as you can see, the Gaurav Gupta outfit what Lisa is wearing has already a lot of shine. So it's always nice to play around a little bit with shine, with shimmer. Guys, you guys can ask questions, anything related like brides or how we work on film industry, right, Lisa?
Sure.
Shaan, do you ever use primers on the eyelids?
No, I haven't used right now any. I wanted to put actually to show you, but I'm not really used to. So there are primers. There's like Smashbox. There's so many other primers in the market. There's Urban Decay. There are so many primers in the market. But today I haven't used because I want to keep it really simple and play around more with lashes and play also around with a liner a little bit. It's because on Lisa's eyes, to define them, it really works. So I want to keep it really simple.
What's the benefit of putting primer on eyelids?
Okay, there is a huge benefit of using this side. There is a huge benefit, guys. Yes, especially if it's a long day, you guys have to use primer, actually. You have to use a primer because it helps you from not creasing the eyeshadow. If you guys see, sometimes you can see a layer of creasing on the eyelid because of then not used primers. But today I'm just doing it quick, like a quick section. So it's not always important, but yeah, if you guys are going for the big day and if it's like the bridal day and all, definitely try to use a primer because it makes the eyeshadow stay much longer.
I've actually noticed a lot of makeup artists also tend to like conceal the eyelids before they put eyeshadow on them, but I don't personally like that.
I don't like it. If you are using a concealer, I would not really prefer
put it on
it.
The eyelids.
Eyelid, because a lot of people do that also,
yeah.
But I would say use a nice primer, which is really important. A primer is definitely better because it's made for the eyelid. I would say I always use a primer for eyelid. But for the face, I don't really use. But I really got some new primers, which I really need to use, try using them. But yeah, there are like, how many of you guys are using primers actually in this room? Yeah, actually everybody is using. Yes, yes, I know, but for me, I would say without a primer. I'm not really a huge primer fan. So now I'm smudging out the rest so that there are no harsh lines. And very soft. Now, I'm going to use the Bobbi Brown. They have this amazing, you guys might think right now, oh my God, why is he using another color? I really don't like to use a highlighter throughout the eyelid. Some people use it really throughout. So what I do is I always take, it can be a highlighter, a special highlighter for the eyes, or you guys can use also an amazing Bobbi Brown bronzer, which is really nice. So I use only really less, and I use very, very little at the arch, only on the top. Can you guys see what I'm doing? So I'm not going to use or spread throughout because then the eyelid looks really heavy and it starts looking like a little bit like heavier and the eyes looks droopy. So what I do is I only use on the top, very little close to the eyebrows. Because if you're wearing something, this really like glittery outfit, of course, the face has to match with the outfit. Otherwise, the face looks very, very blank. So I'm not going to use it throughout. I'm just using close to the eyebrows. How many of you guys love eyeliner? Right? Then guys, you guys have to get, I just found it out recently, the Tom Ford eyeliner. It's amazing, guys. Like there are two pens, like one is like a thick side and one is a thin side, and I guarantee you guys, it is so smooth. But I'm not giving Lisa a full on thick eyeliner. What I'm going to do is I'm going to only give Lisa a really thin line close to the eyelashes. So that
so
defines the eyes really bigger. So I'm not going to do a full eyeliner, like a thick winged eyeliner. And this pen is really good for it. So what I'm going to do, I'm trying to fill only inside the eyelashes. So really thin eyeliner. And this pencil is magic, guys. It's one of the best pencils I've recently come across. Look here, Lisa. Can you guys see how thin it is? But it defines the eye. It really just defines the eye. So I'm going to do the same this side. and it's superb. Like, if you guys are thinking of to buy next eyeliner, this is it. This side for me. This side. Yes. Now I'm going to take a brown shade. And I'm going to smudge on top of that eyeliner so that there are no lines. Like I told you guys, never show harsh lines if you guys are trying to look a soft look. So I'm going to smudge it now. Close it. And again, just close to the eyelashes because that defines the eye the most, especially on films and all when we do the real no-no makeup look. That is how we do the most because there should be actually no lines, how Lisa said.
Actually, what I meant when I said that as well was sometimes when people put on the eyeliner, it's not in the lash line. Like if there's going to be a liner there, it needs to look as though it grew out of your lash line. That's what I meant by no lines. There should never be a point as though it looks as though it's not on your face. Like if you're going to wear the makeup, it should belong on your face. Your face owns it. I woke up like this.
Yes, exactly. She wakes up naturally like that every day. And Lisa has really like lots of lashes. So usually when we used to do films together, I always used to say, Lisa, let's use lashes. And she's like, no, Shaan, I don't really like lashes. But which is true because
on her eyes,
you really don't. Like once I do the mascara, you guys can definitely see the difference. Okay.
Her individual lashes are nice.
Yes, which I'm going to use. I know Lisa likes, so I kept everything what Lisa likes.
How we like Shaan.
So guys, tell me, how many of you use individual lashes? Okay, permanent or you can, you know how to put it yourself.
Up to 4 weeks once.
All right, the permanent ones. Okay, you guys can also do individual lashes. You guys can get packets of individual lashes, which you guys can use on daily use. And I'm going to show you guys how to do that. So now I'm going to smoke out the lower portion also with the same bronze color. So now it's time for the eyelash curling. Hurting you?
Mm-hmm, no.
How many of you struggle with the eyelash curler? No? So it's something which a lot of people are really scared of to use. So you guys can, there. Lisa is live right now. So, okay, when it goes to mascara, I've been using so many mascara, but recently I found this new mascara also. Have you guys heard about Better Than Sex by Too Faced? Yeah, how many of you guys have you used it?
No, never.
It's one of the really latest, and the name is really cool, Better Than Sex. It's like really funny, but it's really a good
Shaan's
mascara.
Like, that's really funny.
That's really funny. It's like Better Than Sex. So, like, you guys know that in Dubai, this mascara got banned because it's called Better Than Sex. You guys know, right? It was the biggest
Shaan,
issue.
I just went live. Don't say it again.
Sorry, so sorry. Oh, my God. I think that's really funny. So, I think we should keep it private.
What brand is it from? Benefit?
This is Too Faced.
Too Faced.
So it really gives you a nice effect. See, guys, can you guys see the difference? And she's like really blessed with really nice lashes. So that's why I'm not going to use a full lash. I'm only going to use individuals. So that is done. And this is my favorite individual lashes. They're really well, like there is, it's an Indian brand. So it's really well, like the lashes, the thickness of the lashes are really nice. Yes, please.
Your skin is done.
Yes, yes. And I'm only going to use in certain areas. In films, you don't use full lashes always. Only if it's a song or if it's a little bit more glamorous kind of scene, we use full lashes. But for films, 90% of the films, if you guys have seen Aashni Co or those kind of films where you really don't need makeup, we really use individuals only. So, and also, like, you also prefer more individuals, right?
I just think they're more comfortable. That's just my personal thing.
Yeah, they are much lighter than because using a heavy lash.
It's not glued onto your whole eyelid, but...
Yes.
Full ones can be nice, too, but I prefer that.
So, I take, like, single ones and look down. And when I do the lashes individuals, guys, I never start it from the end because then it can go like droopy or it really doesn't sit. So what I do is I go from the outside, I take like almost around three-fourths, I keep the first one. And then I start building up on top of it. So like if I've done on 3/4 one, now I'm going to build up on top from that so that it doesn't go droopy and it goes in a really nice line.
What do you mean build up from there?
Because if you guys start from the end of the eyelashes, what happens is, you guys have must have noticed when you start the first lashes on the outer lid. So when you start putting up more and more, the lower one looks really droopy. So what happens is exactly, it goes like straightways. So if you guys start from 3/4 and then start up from the other side, like both the sides, what happens is it lifts up the eye and it doesn't make the eyelid heavy. So it really goes better then.
So you'll put the longest lash at 3/4.
3/4.
And then you'll put smaller ones on...
No. I use the same size. When I go to the inner corner, I use smaller. But still, if you start from here, the lashes already starts drooping from here.
Okay, I'm just...
So, look at me, Babu. So. And now... Can you guys see the difference? So how many of you guys really like eyelashes? I think every girl loves lashes. Every girl loves lashes. Look down.
If you have to throw away every single eyeshadow palette and you are only allowed to keep one,
all right.
Who would it be and why?
Okay, right now, if this is a really good question, but I really don't use always eyeshadow. So for films, especially because I work for films, there's actually one blusher of MAC which I use forever. It has a little bit natural, like a pinky undertone, and it has a little bit sheen of it. And for last 3 years, I can tell you guys, 80% of the films, I've used that blusher as an eyeshadow. So if you ask me this question, which one I would throw away, I couldn't throw away all, but I can never throw away the MAC blusher, which has a pink undertone with golden shimmer because it looks so natural on screen. So I would say that is my favorite, definitely. Sorry?
Is it called Dolly?
It's not Dolly. I'm not carrying it right now, guys. I'm so sorry. You guys can come to my store and I can show it to you guys, because it's actually around 2 years old now. And the writing is fully gone, and I really don't know the name. It's like really weird. A lot of people asked me recently also, but I genuinely doesn't know. But I can show you guys. You guys can click pictures, and it's a MAC blusher. It's like a highlighting blusher.
Did you use it on Jackie in House 4 one time when we were doing the scene with when we came to lie to our dads?
Yes, I have.
And you
used
just
it.
Did like two really big pink cheeks.
Yes.
And then that was it.
Yeah,
yeah, it's a really nice color.
It's a really nice natural color.
I remember.
And it really looks so natural, especially on the screen. The pink also makes it look so natural. So it's a really nice natural color. So please, guys, you guys can come and see what it is. I'm having it downstairs in my kit. So it's a really nice color. You guys can click a picture, and it's dual use. You guys can use it as a blusher also, and then it looks more natural because the eyelid color and the blusher color looks together. So it really, it's really natural. Now guys, the lashes are on. You guys can see it's not perfect. So what I do is I always use, I curl the lashes. Earlier, I used to use this amazing eyelash color from Schumacher, but it's discontinued, like, sadly, because it had no sides, so it was much easier to curl the individual lashes, even if you guys are doing alone. I couldn't find any eyelash curler which has no sides, so usually that was, like, made where you guys can get all the lashes together. But right now, I'm using a full eyelash curler. Look down. And make sure you guys get everything inside it. You, Babu?
No, go for it.
What do you mean? So you guys, can you see? It all blends together and it looks so much more natural, okay? So you guys are going from one side, make sure each of the individual lashes are inside the eyelash curler. And, hurting you?
No, go for it.
And curl them together. So what happens is, can you guys see? It just flares together and it looks really natural. Mm-hmm. Now I'm going to use the same eyeshadow of MAC, which is this chocolatey brown, which is really nice. You guys, as Lisa said also, you guys can fill it also. You can use it on the eyelid also. You guys can even use it for contouring. It's really nice. So I'm going to use this brown color on
it's
her eyebrows.
It's actually the only color I have in my makeup pouch.
Yes, and guys, one more thing. She only introduced me to this MAC eyeshadows. Yes, that is also done by you, because she uses the same color for the brows and eyes. Lisa
brows,
uses
brows, eyes, tip of the nose.
Yeah, tip of the nose, everywhere.
What shade is that?
It is a dark brown. I always go and get it. It's the.
It actually is a brow filler. It's a brow filler color.
It's something.
Mocha minded. Could that
dance
be
in the dark? Dance. Sorry, dance in the dark. This one.
So
I'm keeping it within her eyebrows. I'm not making it heavier or anything.
I think you should explain more about the eyebrows.
Yes. So when I was doing, when we were doing films together, we have realized the more, if you always want to look, get a softer look, we have realized that keep the eyebrows as soft as possible. If you guys are trying to make it really thick and strong, what happens is your face becomes harsh immediately. I know it's a trend right now to have really thick, nice eyebrows, really like defined eyebrows, but it really makes your face very, very harsh. And I've tried it with multiple actresses, with multiple camera people, and we always have realized when you keep the eyebrows as soft within the hairlines, it makes your face softer. So eyebrows are really, really important, and make sure that you guys don't use or make it too strong or too harsh, because that, and also I use sometimes brown, a highlighter kind of a cream on the eyebrows, but right now I'm not using because Lisa has blonde hair, but otherwise I use like a brown mascara to make the face more softer, because the darker the eyebrows goes, the stronger the face looks.
But even if you are doing a bushy, strong brow, there's still a way to make it look like it's not pulling your eyes together, you know?
Yes. What you guys have to do is make
start
sure
from
that
the thickest part.
Yeah, from the thickest part you start, because that's where you need the depth, and then blend with the rest of the color in the front and brush it out, and don't make it too clean. Like, take a brush and then clean it out and keep the natural brows more bushy. Can you guys see it? Can you see? It's not really strong, and I just brushed it out. And I would say always keep your eyebrows like messy, because that looks really nicer. So we are done. And also another trick, you guys, if you guys have a really nice contouring powder also, you guys can use that for your eyebrows, which makes also face really soft. A really nice contouring powder also makes the face really soft. So can we have the straightening machine also? For Lisa, I don't really prefer to use lower mascara, guys, and we don't use it also because that makes Lisa's eyes look a little bit droopy. So, so for films, for a lot of actresses, I don't use lower mascara. Of course, in real life, it looks really nice, and if you guys are going on, but if you have really large almondy eyes, if you use mascara too much on the lower, have you noticed it? It droops your eyes a little bit. So for Lisa, I like to keep it a little bit simple and fresh.